Hollywood. True or false? You answer the question.
Violence runs like a river through my veins.
We are here with Mr. Bob Wayne, the man, the myth.
The legend.
Potentially the legend. Bob, can you tell us a little bit about who you are and how you got here? What brought you here to California?
This Cadillac limousine brought me here, which I got from a funeral home. Pretty much just signed this deal with Century Media. And so that brought me down here to kind of take care of a few things, finishing up the record, and getting ready to put her out.
Now, as I understand it, this vehicle and perhaps another vehicle kind of double as your domicile, if you will, right? You're kind of living on the road.
Yeah. I have a John Deere motorhome, and it's loud. It sounds a lot like...
Not like the sound in the background right now.
Like that. No, it's a pretty decent. It's a 36-foot motorhome. I bought that while I was touring with Hank III when I first started, because I didn't like to pay rent while being on the road. Hollywood, Sin City or Suit City?
And when you tour, do you have a band set up with you? How many guys? Is it just you?
I always have a band. Not always. I've done solo tours, but it's a revolving crew. You know, I'll use guys from Nashville when I'm in the South touring. Right now, I'm going up to Seattle to actually shoot a short film, and. Since I'm in Seattle, I have a crew of guys in Seattle that all know the songs. Well, that also enables me to stay out 250 days a year because I can change band members and not destroy everyone's life, you know?
So, and they just hop in the RV with you.
Yeah, or the limo. We toured, and the last tour we did with the Super Suckers was in this. You know, we usually have a bass right here and then, you know, four guys and merch in the trunk and roll. And I got vans too.
Do you guys get hotel rooms when you're out in the limo, or you sleep in this thing too?
No. Very rarely do we get a hotel room. We once in a while, if times are real tough. We have, fortunately, very, you know, good fan base that is real, like, hospitable. Mm. So we stay on a lot of people's houses,
floors, couches.
That, you know, every night we're staying at, you know, girls' houses, you know. See, a lot of guys, they don't know how to deal with these Hollywood women. You just gotta take them, you know? Like, let's see here. Anything that way? They're all just begging for it. They may not show it off the gate, but they are. We're just looking for a good one. How about over there? Is that a good one? I'll tell you what, just follow me around for a little while. I'll find one.
It is about you that makes this lifestyle something you totally just can live with?
Well, it doesn't matter. I've been on the buses, you know. I've been touring with, I toured with Hank III on a big tour bus, tour managers, hotels, all that. And it doesn't matter if you're on a tour bus or if you're in a limo or if you're in a Pinto, you know what I mean? I've learned that none of that matters. When you're on the road, you're on the road. I don't care if you're getting hotel rooms, if you're getting, you know, a bunk every night. It's just like, for me, I love traveling, and I love seeing everywhere, and I always have, you know, like, that's what got me to touring in the first place, was just being a merch guy. I was like, I just want to be on the road, man. I sold t-shirts for Zeke. Was, like I said, the roadie for Hank 3 for a couple years. I mean, I just want to be on the road.